And we're going to show you how to put our axle kit on a 94 to 2001 Easy Go. And this is the old style 3-bolt steering. And what we mean is when you look at the floorboard where the steering column bolts, it bolts with 3 bolts. The newer style steering would have 4 bolts. Now you need to lift the cart up and place the frame on jack stands and remove your wheels and tires. And then the first step with an 11/16 socket, you want to remove the castle nut. We already took out the cotter pin. Remove the castle nut from both the driver and passenger side steering arms on the spindle. You want to save these for reinstallation. All right, now you want to remove the tie rod ends from the spindle, and we're going to use a pickle fork. Put it on top of the steering arm, and then you drive it in with a hammer, and it will lift the tie rod and allow you to remove it from the steering arm. If you don't have one of these, a lot of times you can get the tie rod out just by tapping on the steering arm with a hammer. You want to do this to both the driver and passenger side. The next step is to remove the king pins from both the driver and passenger side. You want to use 3/4 inch ratchet and wrenches, and you want to save these bolts for reinstallation. Now, using a center punch, you need to remove the kingpin tube from the spindle, which will allow you to remove the spindle. And again, save all this hardware for reinstallation. All right, the next step is using 5/8 inch wrench and ratchet is remove the 3 bolts that are holding the leaf springs to the axle. You want to do this to both driver and passenger side and save these bolts for reinstallation. Got your first one, second one, and third, and then the same on the other side. The next step, using 9/16 wrench, is you want to remove the nut that's holding the shocks to the shock mount on the front axle. Do this to both driver and passenger side and save the hardware. This will allow you to remove the axle from the car. Now we're ready to install the axle. The shock mount goes on the back side, comes up, and goes forward. And then you want to use the stock hardware. Your leaf spring is going to sit on top of the axle. Use the supplied spring plate that comes with the lift kit. And the stock bolts, you want to securely fasten the axle to the leaf springs. Both driver and passenger side. Now that you have the leaf springs securely installed to the axle, you want to install the shocks using the stock hardware to the new shock mounts on both driver and passenger side and securely tighten these bolts. Now we're ready to reinstall the spindles using the stock hardware. Don't forget your thrust washer on top. And before you do this, we already cleaned up the kingpin tube, and you want to put some grease on the kingpin tube. We got it good and clean. Securely install using the stock hardware and washers, both driver and passenger side. Now you're ready to install the steering extensions onto the stock spindle. We're working on the driver's side. It gets put onto the steering arm, and then down through the stock hole of the steering arm is your 1¼ inch bolt, and then your 2-inch bolt goes through the bottom side, but your head must come out towards the tire. You want to go ahead and securely tighten these to both driver and passenger side. Notice how the steering arm comes up and goes towards the back. Now we're going to install the rear lift. We have the body off this car. You don't have to take the body off to install the lift kit, but it makes it easier for you guys to see what's going on. You want to jack the car up. Put the rear of the frame on jack stands,
and put a car jack underneath the rear end housing. All right, remove the wheels and tires, and then with a 9/16 ratchet or socket, remove the stock nut that's holding the stock shock from the bottom shock mount. You want to save this nut for reinstallation and then compress your shock to remove it from the shock mount. Using a 9/16 socket, remove the four nuts that's holding the stock ISO mount. Now that you've got the U-bolts off the ISO mount on both the driver and passenger side, you want to remove the ISO mount from the axle along with the rubber bushing. And the stock shock mount. Using a 9/16 ratchet and wrench, remove the leaf spring from the rear leaf spring mount. Save these bolts for reinstallation. Do both the driver and passenger side. Using a 9/16 and an 11/16, remove the bolt that's holding the front of the leaf spring to the car on both the driver and passenger side. You want to save these bolts for reinstallation. Now that you have the rear leaf springs removed, use the car jack to drop the rear. Jack the rear end up high enough and pull the driver side brake cable out of the stock mount. It's not going to go back in the mount. Once the rear lift is done, you want to take and wire tie this to the frame. Now you're going to reinstall the leaf springs to the stock front mount using the stock hardware. And you're going to install it to the rear mount using the stock hardware. Do not tighten it this time until you get the whole rear lift into place. This lift kit will work with both standard leaf springs and heavy-duty leaf springs. Now you take the new rear risers, sit on top of the axle, use the center pin on the axle as a guide, and the center hole is actually going to go up into the bolt of the leaf spring. Do this to both driver and passenger side. Take the new supplied U-bolts and bring up through the bottom of the riser and around the axle to both the driver and passenger side as shown. Using the car jack, bring the rear end up to center your center pin on the leaf spring with your riser, and then using the stock shock mount, install to the top of the leaf spring with the center pin in the center. And you're going to tighten with the supplied nuts. And then reinstall your shock to the new shock mount using the stock nut. Now that you have everything in place, you want to securely tighten the rear lift. And make sure you use a torque sequence and you show about the same amount of threads in each bolt. And then securely tighten your shock to the shock mount. To both driver and passenger side. And then the last step is to securely install your leaf springs. Install your wheels and tires, double check all your nuts and bolts securely tight, and you're done. Now that we have the lift done, we need to set the front end alignment or the toe. And what you want to do is have the car on the ground, and you want to pick out a tread and measure across from driver's side to passenger side on the front portion of the front tires. And then once you get that measurement, you want to go to the rear portion of the front tires and get the same measurement. When you have the front end set correctly, the front measurement should be 1/8 to 1/4 inch narrower than the rear measurement. It'll be actually what we call toed in.
And if you need to make your adjustments,
you want to go to the driver's side and passenger side tie rods, use a 22 millimeter wrench, and loosen the jam nut. And once the jam nut is loose, there's a knurl on the tie rod that'll allow you to put, I think, what is it, a 9/16? A 9/16 wrench. And you can actually turn the tie rod, which will push the front of the tires in or the front of the tires out, whichever way you need to go. Then do it to both driver and passenger side. And once you got the front end aligned correctly, you want to make sure you retighten your jam nuts.
He has this sitting pretty good. And if you imagine a straight line coming from the rear tire the whole way through the front, you can see the front portion of the front tire just slightly toes in. Then you're done. Just go back and double check all your nuts and bolts to make sure you have everything securely tightened.